Going on, guys. Digital grind, the iPhone 8 Plus. Today we're going to talk about it, if it's still worth it, if you should pick one up, what kind of deals you can get, and why it's worth it in 2020. Let's check it out, the iPhone 8 Plus. What's going on, guys? The iPhone 8 Plus. Let's talk about it, why it's worth it in 2020. Welcome to Digital Grind. This is the first video on the new channel. Let's talk about the 8 Plus. Released in 2017, the 8 Plus was at first thought to be a small upgrade over the 7 Plus. And after diving deeper into the phone, we realized that there are some really good improvements on this phone. And even in today's world, 3 years later, it is still a fantastic phone. And Apple does a lot of great things with their iPhones. We all know that. We all know how efficient they are. And we know that they get software updates for about 5 to 6 years. So moving forward, the iPhone 8 Plus is going to be relevant and going to be very efficient for the next few years still, even today. The iPhone 8 Plus does have a flat display. It is an LCD Retina display. It's not an OLED, so you're not going to get those true blacks. But the screen is very sharp, and as a matter of fact, it's sharper than the iPhone 11, than the XR, and people tend to love those displays, even if they did catch a lot of slack when they were first announced. So the iPhone 8 Plus is very sharp for an LCD screen that is a few years old. You're not going to be disappointed, and it's a big display. It's a 5.5-inch display, and it does have the chin, it does have the forehead, so if you can get past that, you're going to like the display. You can go into landscape mode. A lot of the phones today do not have landscape capabilities, and it's going to remind you of the iPad when you're using this phone, when you rotate it. It does still have Touch ID, not Face ID. I'm a huge fan of Touch ID. I love Touch ID. I'm hoping that in the future that the newer iPhones, maybe the iPhone 12 or the next gen, will have an in-display fingerprint sensor so we can get Touch ID back, because I'm just a huge fan of Touch ID. I've never really liked Face ID. I use it with my iPhone 11 Pro Max, but I still like Touch ID better. I just think it's easier to use. You can leave your phone in your pocket and unlock it whenever you want. And the 8 Plus does have Touch ID. It has Force Touch, which Apple has done away with on their newer phones. I'm a huge fan of Force Touch as well. The build quality is solid on the 8 Plus, a glass back with aluminum edges, and it feels premium when you hold it. Now, because of the glass back, it is very reflective, so you're going to see lots of reflections. And let's be real, it's a fingerprint magnet, so you're going to have to keep it wiped if you don't want to see all the smudges all over your phone all the time. But overall, holding it, holding a XR, holding an iPhone 11, is going to feel very premium. Now, it's not going to feel like the matte frosted finish of the 11 Pro and the 11 Pro Max, but it does feel, when you compare it to every other iPhone ever made, it does feel premium. Let's talk about software. The A11 Bionic is a beast. It still runs everything very smooth. If you were to compare it, now if you do a Geekbench, the numbers are going to differ, but on a day-to-day use, if you compare the 8 Plus with the 10, with the 11, and you're doing day-to-day tasks, you're not going to notice that much of a difference in speed. The A11 is a beast, and it still handles everything smooth as hell. And we all know iOS is very efficient. So combining that with the processor, it has 3 gigs of RAM, which in today's phones, it's not a lot of RAM. But back then, and even today with how efficient iOS is, 3 gigs of RAM is usually good enough to do your daily tasks on a day in and day out basis. So it will be very efficient today and moving forward for years to come, because we will be getting future updates of iOS on the 8 Plus and the iPhone 8. It does come with 64 gigs of storage or 256, and it does come in multiple colors. And the price point that we can get these phones at today, I checked Amazon, I checked eBay, I checked Facebook Marketplace, Craigslist, anywhere between $200 to $400, you're going to be able to find a really good deal. And again, multiple colors. I have the product red, but it does come in black, silver, and gold as well, I believe. But you're going to be able to find a really good deal, especially within the next day or two. This week sometime, the iPhone SE 2 or the iPhone 9, whatever Apple is going to call it, is going to be released, and the 8 Plus will be even lower in price. So you're going to find even better deals moving forward with this phone. So if you're on a budget and you need a phone and you are locked into the ecosystem of Apple, or you just want a newer iPhone, the A Plus is a really good deal. It's a good bargain, and it's going to get better as we move forward this year. So if you're on a budget like most of us are, the A Plus might be a good pickup for you. So the cameras on the A Plus take fantastic photos. Now, we can't compare it to the phones of today, the flagships of today, because we have three more years of upgraded specs in these phones. But when the iPhone 8 Plus was first released in 2017, it was one of the best cameras on any smartphone. So you're going to take really good pictures. Portrait mode takes fantastic shots. Video shoots 4K up to 60 frames per second. And some of the flagships today don't even do that. So really good video and really good pictures, as long as you're not looking for the best of the best. If you want that, then the 8 Plus isn't going to be for you. But if you want to take really good pictures, you're not going to be disappointed by what you get from the 8 Plus. The 8 Plus did come with stereo speakers, which sound fantastic. There is a speaker on the top of the phone and the bottom of the phone, and it works very well. You're not going to be disappointed if you're listening to content. Now, there is no headphone jack, so you will need a dongle if you have the wired connection, but most of us use Bluetooth and wireless speaker or wireless headphones today. You're going to be fine if you have a pair of AirPods. Bluetooth 5.0 will connect no problem. Battery life on here is good. I've never had a problem with the battery life on the iPhone 8 Plus. That was a big difference from the 7 Plus to the 8 Plus. Now, we can't compare it to the size of the batteries that are in today's phones. I believe it had a 2765 milliamp battery in the 8 Plus. And for those of us that are not heavy users, it's going to get you through the day. It was kind of the start of Apple changing direction, because we know in the past, the iPhones did have pretty crappy battery life. But from the 8 Plus and moving forward, the battery life has been much improved by Apple, and it's good for all of us. Look, overall, the 8 Plus is one of my favorite all-time iPhones. Is it worth it today in 2020? If you're on a budget and you are looking to upgrade or downgrade, some people like the downgrade, but if you're on a budget and you want to save a buck, the 8 Plus is a great choice. It's a fantastic phone. It's going to receive updates for many years. It feels premium still. Granted, it does have the chin and the forehead, and if you can get by that, the iPhone 8 Plus is going to be a good pickup. It's going to take good photos. Battery life is going to be good. There are much better phones out today, but overall, the 8 Plus in 2020 is definitely worth it, because you can get it at such a good price. So the iPhone 8 Plus, check it out. But this is Digital Grind, guys. We're talking about the 8 Plus. We got more videos coming soon. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and we will be back soon. Peace.